here's the story. Adam was living in this perfect home that God made him. He had all the animals to play with. I bet he did fun things like wrestle with bears or take naps with lions. He got to name them, and God said, "You only have one rule." "What is it?" said Adam. "You can't eat the fruit on that one tree," said God. "In fact, don't even touch that tree. If you do, you will die." "Okay, God, that's easy." So Adam got to be in charge of everything. He only had one boundary not to cross. But he started to feel like, there's something is missing. He started to feel longing in his heart and loneliness. And he noticed that all the animals had a best friend, a partner, the male and female version. "Where are you, best friend?" he said. He looked and he looked and he talked to God about it every day when they went for walks. But it didn't go away. God knew this. And one day, God put Adam to sleep and he was so full of joy as he made his final creation, Eve, the first woman. And when he introduced them to each other, everybody said, "Now this is really good." Adam and Eve went on all kinds of adventures they never would have done on their own. Like maybe they slept in giant flowers and went climbing up on mountains and high up into trees to look out across the earth. They had a wonderful life until one day they both decided to break the one rule. And when they did, sin and sadness came into their hearts and into the world. God came and said, "What did you do?" And they turned against each other and against God. Instead of saying, "We're sorry, God, forgive us, help us, we made a mess," they said, Adam said, "That woman that you made, God, she made me do it. It's her fault." So Adam blamed God and he blamed his best friend. And the woman said, "That snake tricked me. It's the snake's fault." She didn't take responsibility either. And so because their hearts were hard and full of sin, they had to leave their perfect home. But even then, God loved them. And he made clothes to protect their bodies and keep them warm. And he had a good plan to rescue his people. Today we are learning that God always loves us, even when we try to take charge.